For this example, let's assume that women's heights are normally distributed with a mean of 64 inches and a standard deviation of 3.5 inches. What percent of women have a height more than 68 inches, less than 62 inches, and between 61 and 70 inches? So that's basically the same thing as asking what is the percentage of the population of women that, for example, have a height more than 68 inches. So one thing to recognize is that while we're working with a normal distribution, we're not working with standard normal. In other words, the mean is not zero or the standard deviation is not one. So if you want to use a standard normal distribution table, you're going to need to standardize your x value first. I'm going to go ahead and use the TI-84's normal CDF function to answer this. Okay, so for the first part, I want to know what percent of women have a height more than 68 inches. That is also the same thing as asking what is the probability of randomly selecting a woman with a height more than 68 inches. Okay, so more than will be a greater than case. The normal distribution is a continuous distribution, and the case of equality doesn't matter. So I could have easily included the equality here. Okay, so it's a good habit to sketch what's given and what you're looking for. So the mean is 64. And the x value I'm given is 68, and that is above the mean. And I have a greater than case, so I want to shade to the right. So if you wanted to use the z table for this, you would have to standardize. So if you wanted to do that as a z score, this would be 68 minus 64 divided by 3.5. Okay, and then use z table or the standard normal table. Okay, so that is one way to do this. I'm going to go ahead and use the normal CDF function in the calculator. So going to my distribution menu, selecting normal CDF, my lower bound is 68, my upper bound is theoretically positive infinity, although that would not make sense when we're talking about height. But for this purpose, all you need to do is put in a 1, a positive 1, and a bunch of zeros. Now this is left over from a previous example. The mean is not 100 and the standard deviation is not 15. I need to change that to match the problem. Okay, so I have 64 and 3.5 for mu and sigma respectively. And then entering again, rounding to 3 decimal places, I get 0.127. So to answer the question, about 12.7% of the population of women have a height more than 68 inches. For the next part, we want to find the probability that we get a woman less than 62 inches. And that will also give us the percent of the population of women whose height is less than 62 inches. It's essentially the same question. So again, I want to sketch what's given. So I have x less than 62. Drawing something reasonably close to a bell curve with 64 in the middle. 62 is below the mean. And I'm shading to the left. Now, because I'm shading less than half of the bell curve, I expect my area or my probability to be less than 0.5. Going to my normal CDF function in the calculator, going back to the distribution menu, selecting 2, My lower bound now is an extremely small number, so I want to put in a negative 1 and a bunch of zeros. And my upper bound now is 62 because I'm stopping at 62. And then I want to keep mu and sigma the same. And then rounding to 3 decimal places, I get 0.284. So to answer the question, what percent of women have a height less than 62 inches? That's going to be about 28.4%. All right, last but not least, we want to find the percent of women who have a height between 61 and 70 inches. So that is also the same thing as randomly selecting a woman whose height is between 61 and 70 inches. So in probability notation, this is going to be the probability 61 is less than X is less than 70. Okay, so I have a between case. Again, I want to sketch what's given. I have a mean of 64. I'm starting at 61. And I'm stopping at 70. And 70 is above the mean. And then I want to shade in between there because all of these x values here satisfy the condition of being both greater than 61 and less than 70 at the same time. Now, if you're going to use your z-table for this, you would have to standardize both endpoints of this interval. And then you would have to use the table twice. You'd have to find the larger area up to the positive z-score and subtract out the smaller area up to the lower z-score. If you use the calculator, it's less work. So I'm going to go back to the normal CDF function, back to my distribution menu. Now my lower bound is 61 and my upper bound is 70. So changing those, and it kept mu and sigma from the last part. Rounding to 3 decimal places, I get 0.761. So about 76.1% of the population of women have a height that falls between 61 and 70 inches.